I'm a Bubba, and my name is Bubba. It's kind of like being a Baptist, you know. It's both a culture and a religion. And I'm a Baptist. We don't believe in premarital sex, but only because we're afraid it might lead to dancing. And I'm a Southern Baptist. We don't even believe in synchronized swimming. I'm just a big Bubba. You know, I really am big. You get on an elevator with me later, you need to be going down. I got out of the shower a while ago getting dressed to come down here and shower, and just turned around in my room, and there was a full-length mirror. I looked in there, and I could see my behind without turning around. That's too big. I'm just big. People discriminate against you. You know, they really do. It ain't easy being this big. Southwest Airlines. You know, here they are. You heard about that in the news. You got to buy 2 tickets on Southwest now if you fold over into the other seat a little bit. I took great offense to that. And then I thought, you know, I got to buy 2 tickets. Hey, 2 meals. That's all right. I got right into it, you know. And I can't even participate in the safety drill if they have one. I'm watching that lady give that announcement to you. You know, I even brought it here to show it to you. You know, it says right here what to do in the event of an emergency landing. Got a big picture of it here. It said, put your head between your legs. I can't do that. This is about as far as I can get right there. I'm going to die. Besides that, who wants to die like that anyway? Not me. I want a better view than that when I go. And then the other announcement. I don't understand that one. It says, in the unlikely event that the cabin should lose its air pressure, an oxygen mask will fall out of the ceiling, place it around your face, and breathe normally. Right. I'm headed towards certain death at 800 miles an hour. I got no oxygen. They want me to breathe normally. I'm going to be sucking on that hose like a hippo in a marathon. And if there's a small child sitting next to me, I'm going to take his oxygen mask too. I belong to the workout school of thought. No pain, no pain. I believe if you pick up a heavy thing that makes you go, put it down. God did not mean for you to pick that up. Jog. Now, I'll take up jogging if I ever seen one of them smiling and jogging at the same time. They look like they're in tremendous pain. I jogged one time my whole life. I'll never forget it. April 4th, 1988, I jogged for 0.5 mile. It's the worst 3 hours of my life. I got to going down a hill. My big old belly out there, I'm running down a hill. I got ahead of myself and couldn't catch up. It's hard to catch up with yourself. I got my thighs rubbing together. Foo, 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 foo. So much friction down there, my underwear caught on fire. About 10 years ago, I wanted to lose 20 pounds. Doctor put me on a dehydrated food diet. I ate dehydrated food for 6 months. One day I got caught in the rain. I gained 127 pounds in 10 minutes. Still got the stretch marks from that one. You know, I try, I diet, I do. Doctor put me on a diet in January, January 3rd. Didn't have much food on it. I had to go on 2 diets to get enough to eat. Doctor said, Bubba, you got to eat more fiber. You got to eat fiber. I ate fiber, 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 fiber for 6 months. Last week, I passed a wicker basket. It's like about 5 years ago, one day God said, let's have some fun with Bubba. Let's suck half the hair off the top of his head and blow it out his nose and ears. I got hair in my ears. That's not right. It shouldn't be in there, but it is. And then Bubba will usually have a big old belt buckle on. Not always, but he'll have a belt buckle. You know, that's a nice belt buckle, ain't it? What's it look like? I can't see it. It's down there, ain't it? Very good. Not a very good seat you got there. A lot of pressure on this buckle. My belt breaks, you're gonna die. Boom! I'm not dumb. I'm just a little confused. I mean, I got a high school diploma and an AA degree, and I finished University of Southern Mississippi in 1974. I didn't graduate, but I did finish. I was sitting in advanced algebra one day and raised my hand. I said, I'm finished. They said, go on, Bubba. So I did. That's what I did. Things confuse me. Science confuse me. I'm doing a show in New Hampshire last week, and I'm driving from New Hampshire into Vermont on I-89. As I crossed over the state line there's a sign in Vermont the highway department put there that says, pavement wet when raining. Now, where I come from, that's pretty obvious. But you got to tell people in Vermont that. I just got out and took a picture of it. That confuses me. Why do they have to do that? There's a boot store on Broadway in Nashville. Had a sign to win it for 2 years. Says boots. Buy two, get one free. What you going to do with three boots, man? You'd never get them all worn out at the same time. You know, it's just crazy. I saw signs everywhere. I saw a sign in Pizza Hut the other day. On the oven, it says, caution, door may open. I hope so. How else am I going to get my pizza? I'm driving by Captain D's Seafood. Big old high sign said, all you can eat, drive through. I thought to myself, you know, it's going to take me two tanks of gas just to have lunch. Signs, they're just everywhere that I don't understand. I saw one the other day, a little birthday party, said live pony rides. Obviously, he wasn't doing much business with dead horses. It's not much fun pulling a kid around a circle on a dead horse.